have a cupcake liner or a muffin tin? No worries, I got you covered. So today we're gonna make these parchment muffin liners that are more square in shape. You'll need parchment, and the size that I have over here is 6 by 6 inches square. The first step is to fold it in half, making sure that everything is aligned before creasing it really well. Now, my nails are on the longer side, so it makes it easier to make the sharp creases, but if you have shorter nails, you can use the back of a knife for the same effect. We want to fold a sheet in half twice so you see a cross-shaped crease. I'm moving a bit slower in this video so you can follow along. The next step is to make diagonal creases. This part is straightforward. So basically, you need to fold the corners of the sheet towards the center. The parchment might be a little slippery, but listen, you got this. Once you crease the parchment, the folds will not budge, which is a huge advantage. I also recommend taking your time folding, especially if it's your first time with origami. I find this origami in particular super easy though, but it's nice when you take your time in the first attempt. Once you get a feel for it, you'll go faster because you'll understand the folds and the rhythm. It's kind of like kissing. Now we're less than halfway there. Fold the bottom and top halfway towards the center until you see a rectangular shape. Again, the parchment might get a little slippery, but if you place your fingers down firmly on the folds, you'll be fine. Give it a good crease a couple times because we are going to now unfold the flaps. When you unfold the two flaps you just creased, the parchment will sort of want to return to its original state of how it was folded. You don't want to remove or reverse the creases you just creased, but you want to slightly flatten the sheet so it's easier to work with. Just quickly lay your hands over it somewhat firmly as to flatten the sheet, and then fold the top and bottom halfway towards the center again. This step is crucial because what we're trying to do over here is that we're trying to create folds that will later hold the box together without the use of glue or even food. And the final step is here. We're almost done, guys. Unfold the two flaps you just created. These flaps will eventually be the sides of our square muffin liner. We're going to assemble the box now. I find this part the most difficult to explain, and I find it easier to see how it's done instead. If you look at the folds you just created, you will see a square with an X-shaped crease in the middle, with folds that look like rectangular boxes around the square. Basically, the square is the bottom of your liner, and the rectangular shapes are the sides of your box. If you look carefully here, I am reversing the crease on the corners of the flaps so I can fold a flap over to create a wall for the box. You need to do this for both sides of the box. I also gave it another crease once I pulled the flap over. Creasing a lot will help make your box sturdier and less wobbly. Here's a good view of me reversing the fold and pushing it inward so I can finish this muffin liner. It's not tricky at all. Once you reverse fold it, I find that the parchment really gives in to form that square-shaped muffin liner. Though I've used a 6 by 6 inch parchment square, I have tried it with larger sizes up to 8 by 8 inch squares, and it still works as a liner for muffins perfectly well. It's a great technique if you don't have muffin liners or a muffin tray lying around. Though you do need to bake these guys on a baking tray such as a cookie sheet since they're small and they can fall in between a baking rack. You'll also notice loose flaps near the center of the box, but don't worry about it. Once you place the batter on top, they will flatten into place, and that's it. You're done. You now have a square-shaped muffin liner or even a mini baking tray. Here's a bit of the baking process behind the scenes when the muffin liners are filled halfway. When there's less batter, the shape of the liners was still solid, but when I filled the batter all the way to the top, the shape of the liner slightly got distorted, though there was absolutely no leakage in any of the liners that I made. It didn't bother me in terms of distortion, but if you want that sharp square shape, then less batter is the way to go. And look at that, how cute is that? It's a nice way to do single servings too. This is a muffin liner that I filled with a batter halfway towards the top, and as you can see, the sides and the butt are perfectly cooked. There's not a lot of caramelization, which is what we want for a smaller and flatter cake. If you just tip the liner upside down, the cake will just slide out of the liner effortlessly, which is a thing of beauty. And there we go, a perfectly cooked mini cake. Here's the other muffin that I've filled all the way to the top. And again, it's perfectly cooked. There's more caramelization towards the bottom, but that is to be expected because the more batter you use, the longer the cooking time. And what I really appreciate about the muffin liner here is that the bun is consistently tanned with that caramelized color, which makes it also look visually aesthetic. And I find it interesting to see that the side's not as caramelized though, which is actually really nice. So if you wanted to make a teeny weeny tiered cake, you can totally do it without the need of trimming every browned edge or by using multiple pan sizes. So that's about it for this week. I hope you liked this video. And if you found it helpful, make sure to like and subscribe so I can keep creating some quirky cake related content. And I'll see you guys next week.